when I was first diagnosed, my doctor said, probably by the time you are 40, you will be in a wheelchair. Today, I'm 43 years old. There is not a wheelchair in sight. My name is Jimmy Choi, and I was diagnosed with young onset Parkinson's at the age of 27. I met Cheryl in high school, actually, so we were high school sweethearts.
He was the jock. I was the nerd in high school.
It was two proms and one homecoming, and then we got married almost immediately after we graduated from college. My dad always said, when you get married, ready to start a family, you buy life insurance, protect your family. So that's what I did, and it was actually the nurse that came out and did my physical that noticed things about me that I had never even thought of before. I didn't want to believe that it was Parkinson's. I felt powerless because I didn't know what Parkinson's was. I took the medication, and for the next 8 years, my regimen never changed. I started gaining quite a bit of weight, actually. It was about 240 to 250 pounds, and I was falling over quite a bit, so I had to walk with a cane. Everything became hard, so frustration was set in. My rock bottom moment really came when I was carrying my then 10-month-old son, Mason, down the stairs, and I lost my balance, and the two of us went tumbling down an entire flight of stairs.
It was terrifying.
Is this what I have become? A safety hazard to my family?
Nice job. Way to hustle out there, huh?
That fall made me think, what can I do to better my situation? There is no cure. It made me want to see what I can do to change that. There were clinical trials out there, all over the place. So I figured, hey, that was gonna be what I can do. A lot of the studies that have been done in recent years are around exercise.
I first became interested in studying the effect of exercise on people with Parkinson's disease in about 2001. My area of scholarship is to look at how you activate a muscle when you make a movement. People with Parkinson's disease are weak, so a combination of being weaker and having abnormal muscle activation patterns led me to propose a research study to look at the effect of resistance exercise. Progressive resistance exercise dramatically reduces the signs of Parkinson's disease. And that's what we showed.
The exercise protocol that Jimmy has just been using, the details were published in the New York Times last year.
So people, as a result, they were stronger, they were faster, their muscle activation patterns improved, and they were very happy.
The more physical activity that I was doing, it was making me feel better. And I figured, you know what, if this is making me feel better, I'm gonna do more of it. When I told Karina that I was gonna be on American Ninja Warrior for the first time, I think she squealed louder than anything I've ever heard. She was certainly more excited than I was. For me, it was panic. You know, what did I get myself into?
So Northwestern Medicine kind of came in to help. What does it mean for him to take on that challenge? And also, what does that mean for his medication and training?
Today, compared to 8 years ago, I'm about half of the medication that I used to take. It's not just halting the progression. It really is giving myself back a couple of years that I may have lost.
So if you have Parkinson's disease, a lot of things go wrong. And so you need all kinds of specialists to help you. And major medical centers have access to that. They have terrific expertise, and they can actually help with all aspects of the disease.
When I think about my care team at Northwestern, I think about my friends, because over the years, that's what they have become. They accept my craziness in terms of trying to get to that next level, and I think that made a great relationship. People ask me all the time, you run, you know, a marathon in 3 hours and 40 minutes, or you're able to compete on American Ninja Warrior for 3 years in a row. Can you imagine how much stronger you would be or how much faster you would be if you weren't diagnosed with Parkinson's? My response is very simple. If I was never diagnosed with Parkinson's, I wouldn't be doing these things.